Dear reader, this little book is designed to tell you everything you need to know about the science of getting ahead. Now, let us assume you are a young, healthy, clear-eyed and eager, anxious to rise quickly and easily to the top of the business world. You can.
I can.
If you have education and intelligence and ability, so much the better. But remember that thousands have reached the top without any of these qualities. Just have courage and memorize the simple rules of the chapters that follow. If you truly wish to be among the lucky golden few, you can.
I can.
How to apply for a job. How to advance from the mailroom. How to sit down at a desk. How to dictate memorandums. How to develop executive style. How to commute in a three-button suit with a weary executive smile. This book is all that I need.
I'm the personnel manager, and we're not hiring anyone today.
But Mr. Bigley told me to see you.
Bigley?
Yes, ma'am.
J.B. Bigley.
Yes, ma'am, he told me to come see you.
J.B. Bigley himself, you were speaking to him.
We kind of just bumped into each other.
How's your friend, Morris?
Ma'am, I don't think a man should trade on friendship just to get a job.
Very well put, young man. Well, if you step into my office, I'm sure we can work something out. My name is Brad, and you are...
Fitch. Pierpont Fitch.
Hey, maybe that ought to be J. Pierpont Fitch.
As a matter of fact, it is.
Well, step into my office.
Thank you. my coffee break, something within me died.
No, I'm just kidding.
Why not?
Well, from Bud Crump's description of you, I mean.
Well, thank
you. If it's not out best for me to say, I think you're a very attractive person, no matter what Bud Crump says.
What did you say your name was again?
Finch. Hereupon Finch. F-I-N-C. I'm not supposed to deliver the executive mail. That's his job. Bud Frump. F-R-U-M-P.
Very interesting. Thank you, man.
You're welcome, Miss Jones.
Say, Jonesy, I would like an appointment with the boss on round 3 ish.
I'll check up Milt and let you know.
Is that a flower?
Got a new boyfriend, Jonesy?
This flower was given to me by a very young, nice man. You should know him. Finch?
Yes?
Finch, this is Mr. Gatch.
Oh, well, how do you do, Mr. Gatch?
Mr. Gatch would be very interested for you to know. His department is very important.
Oh, I know about Mr. Gatch. He's in charge of client assistance, interdepartmental evaluation, pre-promotional promotion, and multiple development on a multi-level level.
Say, Jonesy, this is a smart one.
I didn't know I did all that. Very fine man, Mr. Gatch. I hear he has an opening in his department.
Yes, he has. He hasn't been able to make his mind. Well, thank you for flowering me.
You're welcome, Miss Jones.
Hi, Jonesy.
Miss Jones.
Say, Rose.
Finch, quit goofing off. You've got to give us a second delivery.
I know, buddy boy. I gotta get back to work. Thanks for the flower, Rosemary.
Thanks for the flower? You gave my flower to Miss Jones.
Rosemary, surely you don't begrudge an old woman a moment happens.
Yes, it is important for you to be nice to Miss Jones.
I'm glad you understand that. I'll see you later, Rosemary.
Well, Rosemary, how are you doing?
Why do you please. Smitty, what's the opposite of a sex mania?
A businessman.
Hello, give me an outside line. No, this call is not personal. I'm calling my mother. Thanks. One of these days, when I'm running the show around here, I'll clear out the whole... Hello, mother? Oh, but I know I left without my sweater, but it's warm. Now look, mother, there's going to be a new head of the mailroom, and I want the job. You've got to call Aunt Gertrude and tell... I know I'm next in line, but there's this new fellow working here that has me worried. Oh, he works hard, comes in on time, he's polite, you know, a real rat.
Yes, Miss Jones?
Mr. Bigley, your wife is calling.
Damn it. Tell her I'm in a meeting. Tell her I'm out. Damn it, put her through. Hello, Gertrude. Glad you called. Oh, what's on your mind? I'm busy. Well, Gertrude, I can't help but there. The head of the mailroom should choose his own successor. Well, I can't switch the signal in the middle of the play. That would upset the whole team. If I interfere now, that would be nepotism. Nepotism. That's where your nephew is a damn fool! Miss Jones! I thought I told you speaking with my wife upsets me. Never mind that, just, where's my, you know.
Right in the back, right hand by the door.
Well, let's get going, boys.
Yes, ma'am, Miss Ripple, I've already started sorting. Thank you, ma'am. Coming from you, that means a lot.
Hello, mailroom ring. No, mailroom. Just a second. It's a call for you to invoke Miss Bratton and personnel.
Ah, so maybe you're here for a call for some of us. Hello?
What's the idea, Finch?
What's the idea of what, bud?
You're trying to butter up Twindle. Well, believe me, it won't do you any good.
Good job. But just because I pay a woman a compliment doesn't mean I have to have an angle.
Well, if anybody's going to get this job, you know.
I got you, Miss Bratton. Thanks very much. Well, boys,
congratulations.
Who's going to be the new head of the mailroom?
Well, I would say until it's official, but Ms. Ratt said she's going to do the twist up to me. Twimble, she said. The mailroom is the nerve center of my organization. You've an outstanding mailroom head, and we want you to choose your successor. And we want you to choose my merit. My merit? Alone.
That's not fair! I'm going out for a smoke.
Smoke? He's going to call his mother. But it's not going to help him if I have anything to say. I have somebody else in mind for this job.
Miss Twimble?
Yeah?
Have you been with the company long?
A long, long time. Last month, I became a quarter of a century woman.
That's beautiful. A quarter of a century.
A quarter of a century.
How long have you been in the mailroom?
25 years. Yep, it's not easy in a middle like this. It takes a combination of skill, diplomacy, and bold caution. When I join this firm as a brash young girl,
Yes, J.D., it's Brad.
It's the big boss.
Oh, I understand your problem, J.D.
Actually, we have picked someone else. But that's all right, Jamie. The young fellow who picked for the job over to Bud.
He thinks Bud is better qualified. No, he doesn't seem to be out of his mind. He was explaining about it when he called. Go ahead, Finch.
Well, the great thing that you taught me, Mr. Scribble, is that no individual is as great as the whole company.
He says no individual is as great as the whole company.
The whole team is greater than any one player.
The whole team is greater than any one player.
The whole crew is greater than any one oarsman. The whole salad is greater than a piece of lettuce.
The whole salad. Oh, you can hear him.
Oh, well, the whole omelet is greater than any one egg.
Isn't that great, J.B.? Sort of chokes you up, doesn't it? His name? It's Finch.
F-I-N-C-H.
F-I-N-C-H. Yeah, right. Well, I'll keep an eye on him myself. See you later, J.B. Finch is going out the spot with Mr. Bailey.
We'll find out, Miss Brown.
I appreciate it. Good luck, Uncle.
Oh, say, Miss Scribble, don't I have to take this letter to, Mr. Gatch?
Gatch?
Gatch.
Gatch?
Gatch.
Say, I just remembered, Mr. Gatch is looking for a junior executive in his department.
He is. Me, a junior executive?
Your generosity and confidence may prove to be a really good thing.
Well, by George, ethical behavior always pays off.
Finch, you did a very wise thing.
Oh, well, that doesn't matter. I did what was right.
Boys and girls, meet the new head of Canelo, Bud Crump.
Thanks, Tomfield man.
Good luck, Bud.
Come along, Finch. I want to talk to you.
I still don't understand, Mobile. I'm still wondering why you did this to me.
So am I. I still think my original choice of man was best.
Now, wait a minute, Mobile. Ponte, okay?
It's just that...
We'll have no renegade. I was promised this job.
Wait a minute, Bud. I've been here a long time. A quarter of a century. I just want to make sure things are done the right way.
I know what you mean, Miss Wimble. From now on,
I'll play the company way. Wherever the company puts me there, I'll stay.
Whatever the company tells me that I will do.
Whatever my uncle may think, I think so. They'll ever pin on me.
The wrong way is the company way. Executive policy is my hero way.
I'll never be president, but there's one thing clear. As long as my own can stand me, I will still be here.
No, the company may not grow up.
I'm so proud.
They choose you to help me.
I'm happy.
They will never come from the company man. From the way.
Executive club up on the roof.
Me in the executive club.
Well, I know. Now that you're my new junior
executive.
I can afford to go to my expense account.
Well, thank you, Mr. Ketchup. I'll get my coat.
Cool, I'll meet you by the elevator. Seeing you always brings my day.
Oh, please, Mr. Gatch!
That's not pretty playboy.
Whisper, I have a wonderful surprise for you. I've been invited to lunch in the executive club room.
Lunch?
Yes, how do I look?
You look fine, Patrick.
Yeah.
A second, let's go.
Teeth.
How soon would you be interested in a thing like that?
I'm very interested in the hobbies of people I like.
Say, would you like to come watch us bowl tonight?
Oh, well, I would love to, but I have to work tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Tomorrow's Saturday. Nobody around here works on Saturday.
Conti, you're a very unusual boy. You'll go far.
Well, thank you, Miss Jones. Coming from you, that means a lot, because you're Mr. Beagley's secretary. He's a man I most want to emulate. He's so kind and caring. I heard when he listened to check to his old college in Harvard, wasn't it?
Harvard? Don't let JB hear you say that. He's a brownie.
But where did he go to college?
Old Ivy. Well, good night.
Good night, Miss Jones.
Don't work too hard.
Oh, don't worry, I won't.
Hello, stranger.
Hi, Rosemary. I'm sitting.
Hi, Conti. Been a long day, haven't
it? Sure has.
Haven't seen you much since you got your new job.
I've been working pretty hard.
Been a long day.
Yeah.
Say, Rosemary, where are you having dinner tonight? That depends.
On what?
Where are you? Dinner?
Oh.
Facets, which are very important to the scheme of things. Sweetheart, you've
I guess it's a wonderful job. Head cigarette girl, the copa.
But you said you didn't like the surroundings. All those men staring at you and making advances.
It's no different around here. At least at the copa, when I got pinched, I got ticked.
Someone called. <down.
laughs> Yes, it's a large corporation with rule-like classes. There are many more wicked switch. Who hit you?
I don't care about that. Look, you did not put your part of my bargain.
Sweetheart, angel, I meant every word. Tell you what, I'll meet you at your place in 10 minutes. But Angel, well, yes, this is a large operation like worldwide wickets. There are many people who pass it. Very important thing. Why won't you go home?
I'm waiting for the elevator.
Why don't you walk down?
It's 30 floors.
Why don't you jump? Very attractive girl, isn't it? Yes, I was just trying to make her feel at home. She seems to be a rather shy young lady. You go ahead and do that, JB. I'm heading home to have dinner with Mother. She loves dinner with me. I tell her everything that happens in the office.
Finch, when did you graduate?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I was thinking about the big game today. Replace the chipmunks.
Yeah, I hope those damn chipmunks don't give us too much trouble.
Oh, they won't, sir. Chernowski's new is doing much better.
With Chernowski in there, the team's morale should pick up. He's the dirtiest player we've got.
Well, even though we're not there in person, we'll be cheering for him. Right, sir?
Right.
Groundhog! Groundhog!
F-I-N-C-H. Oh, I ought to know. I was working with him all weekend.
Well, yes. Well, I don't know. Let's give him a corner office. One of the best available. Oh, nothing too fancy, though. We don't want him getting any ideas.
Entire time.
I liked it. There was one thing, though, Ponty. Later, when we said goodnight. No, it was our first date and everything, and I don't want you to get the wrong impression of me, but... Well, I guess it's natural for a guy to get a little fresh with a girl and try and make pass her. And you didn't do anything.
Well, I had to get up early. Sir, miss.
Hi, Miss LaRue, haven't you?
Oh, what can I do for you, Miss LaRue?
A secretary's order to be assigned to you. I'm your assignation. You didn't work in the cemetery.
I just found out myself.
Well, have patience, Bobby. Bye.
Won't you have a seat? Now, Miss LaRue.
Oh, just call me Hetty.
I think in a business relationship.
You. So cute.
Excuse me for a moment.
Choosing a secretary can be fraught with peril. Take a good look at the young lady who has been assigned to you. If she is so attractive that you feel things are too good to be true, be very careful. It may be that one of the big men in the company is interested in her career. There is a simple test for this. Check on her secretarial skills. The smaller her ability, the bigger her detector.
Miss LaRue, let's try some dictation. Take a letter.
Okay, shoot.
This is to Mr. Gatch.
Mr. Gatch.
Dear Mr. Gatch, pursuant to our discussion...
Wait a minute. Are you trying to catch a train?
what are you taking this down?
In long hand, it's much safer. I make up for it when I type.
Oh, you type it.
Like a jackrabbit, 12 words a minute.
Miss LaRue, Hetty, what did you do before you came here?
I was in the tobacco business, and then Mr. Bigley got
me. Mr. Bigley?
Yes, he got me interested in the Wiccans, and I matriculated myself to business school, and here I am.
Here you are.
Dictate some more. I'm going to like this jazz.
Let the letter wait. And here, take this to Mr. Gatch.
Mr. Gatch?
Yes, he's my boss. Now, make sure you take it to him yourself. Huh? Hetty? Personally.
Okay, Jenny. Mr. Gatch's office. One moment, please. Mr. Gatch, Mr. Finch's secretary is outside and she'd like to see you personally.
Have her come in.
Mr. Gatch.
Yes?
I'm the secretary. He asked me to give this to you.
Say, what are you doing tonight?
I've got a date with my gentleman friend.
Oh, come on. You're in the big time now. Cool around the small fry.
Mr. Gatch, he's been transferred to one of our out-of-town offices. Venezuela.
Rosemary, where have you been? I haven't lunch without you. Smitty, I
invited to the executive party on the roof tonight. Haunt will be there too. Oh, Smitty, I've been dreaming for a chance like this. Haunt has never seen me all dressed up. You know, glamorous. Do you know what this is?
Your lunch?
This is the key to how to succeed with Finch. A new dress, and it's just beautiful.
Well, good luck, Rosemary. I hope it works.
Thanks, Smitty.
You know, I think maybe I'll get a new dress for tonight, too.
Good idea. I hope you're very popular tonight at the party, Smitty.
Maybe I will be at that. I'm thinking of starting a secret rumor that I'm a nymphomaniac.
Original, all sneaky with sin.
10 out of 5.
Which way is the booze?
Right. Oh, Martini.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, our advertising department has been in trouble for some time, but I feel we have found a solution. This is Benjamin Burton Daniel Owens. He's going to be the new vice president in charge of advertising.
I just want to say that I'm proud to join this worldwide Wicked family. I don't know very much about Wiccans, but I do know about advertising. My view of advertising can be summed up in one sentence.
Shut up!
Down there, don't put that little soft set.
Good sound, Wiccan.
And I would like to say,
Benjamin, aren't you saying you love Wiccan? What the hell kind of name is that?
But I would like to
you
say,
you call this a double martini? There's only one bullet in it!
Everybody dance!
For the ball!
Come on, Betty! Betty, no kidding! Come on! Jakey wants me to take you home.
Fine, you have to hurt the rumor!
Rosemary.
Rosemary.
Betty's.
What about that kid?
convention.
Presented in front of the whole board.
Now, Fitch, your vice president in charge of advertising. You know what? So far, I'm pretty dissatisfied with your work.
Well, I don't care what happens, I'm vice president.
Vice president Fitch.
Hello, stationery room. Remember those letters I told you to send out? We'll go ahead and send them all out. All right. Come out now, Rose.
Thanks, Rosemary.
Rosemary, I have some wonderful news for you. I've been promoted to vice president in charge of advertising.
Congratulations. Can I be your secretary?
Well, that would be wonderful, Eddie, but Rosemary is going to be my secretary.
Guess I'll go back to the settle pool. I'll have to wait for that question until after you move in.
Rosemary.
I'm going to be your secretary.
Well, yes, you're Mr. Olvington's secretary.
And what makes you think I'd want to be your secretary? I'd rather die.
Rosemary, you must. You have to. You know what a big job that is. Rosemary, I need you.
Who?
Well, that case. All right, I guess I'll be your secretary.
Right, now let's get to work.
Finch, aren't you forgetting something?
All right. Hello, operator? Who paints names on doors?
Finch, aren't you going to kiss me?
I'll kiss you. I can't.
Why not?
Because you're my secretary. Now, hold on, Rosemary. Hello, name painter?
Hello, name painter.
Yes, I write my name in gold leaf. Finch.
Me too! I only told the girl.
You will forgive him.
Never.
I promise you.
Rosemary, there's one thing you can overlook, and that's
the I've been very loyal to him.
I don't mean to him.
I mean to us. Us girls.
Source. Be alert. You never know who will bring it to you.
My favorite style, Chinese provincial. I suppose you're wondering why I'm here.
Frankly, yes.
Ponty, I want you and me to be friends. You know, smoke a peace pipe. You've never liked me.
Oh, but it's...
Don't deny it. It's true. I've been no good backbiting thing.
Well, but that's a bit strong.
How would you put it?
I guess you're way too best.
Well, Ponty, I want to change all that. Look, I heard you stuck an idea, and I was...
not stuck for an idea.
I was thinking giveaway shows are going
but
to come
I
back
don't...
in.
What was that?
Well, I have this idea for a giveaway program called the Worldwide Cricket Treasure Hunt. We had $1,000 savings bond, and each week on television we give a clue as to where it is. Look, Ponty, as you say, you don't need an idea. But let me leave this with you. And if you get a chance, look it over. Because the meeting's in a few little while. I mean, soon.
But what did your uncle say when you brought this?
Oh, I haven't brought it to him, Ponty. If I were to bring it to him, he wouldn't listen. That's why I brought it to you.
You haven't shown this.
No, Ponty, look, if you're not interested...
It doesn't give me much nourishment, but I'll look it over and give it a thick thing.
Feel free to use it. I have returned!
Treasure box. Got another bomb. Nah, this thing is gonna twist.
Ponty, I'm back. I've changed my mind.
Oh, hello, Ponty.
Well, I don't blame you for being cold to me, but I did change my mind.
About what?
About what I said in the letter.
What letter?
My letter of resignation.
Oh, to what?
From the Girl Scouts of America.
Oh.
Don't you understand? I quit. Resigned. Left me forever.
Well, why'd you do that?
Because I was hurt, humiliated, ignored, upset.
Who did that to you?
You!
Me? You couldn't have been me. I haven't said 10 words to you all week. True? Good. Now, listen, Mr. Pinchin.
Don't you call me that? I can't call me Rosemary.
No, and I want you to call me Mr. Finch until you're Mrs. Finch.
Really? Mrs. Finch?
I thought we were past that.
Keep thinking maybe you forgot.
Well, I haven't. You're going to be Mrs. Finch because we're going to be married. Now, maybe we discuss some more serious matters.
Oh, sure.
Miss Pinchin?
Yes?
I finally come up with a new television program. I'm thinking of calling it the Worldwide Wicked Treasure Hunt. The prize could be $1,000 bond, 25. Listen carefully, Rosemary. What would you say if I gave away 100,000? 200,000.
Oh, I don't care if you give away the whole company. I love you.
Say that again.
I love you.
No, before that. That is it. We will give away the whole company. Not the whole company. We will give away stock in the company. And I even have time to think of this. I'll talk to Mr. Big. No, I'll myself.
Good luck, Mr.
Big. Oh, thank you, Mr.
Bigg. Seth, what about taking me to lunch? Nobody has to see us.
Spokington?
I'm sorry, Mr. Big.
Hetty, what kind of future is there demonstrating shark belly jelly?
More than the ones around here.
You have to be patient.
No, I made up my mind. Go on, fire up.
Good luck, dear.
Huh?
Oh, I'll manage somehow, only how I wait to spend those lonely nights.
You could go home.
I can go home. I'm a married man.
Honey,
I know I see my eye in everything.
I'm so happy I could cry.
Ordinarily, I'd agree with you. Finch is very smart. But he's an advertiser now, and that does something to men's brains. Oh. Has anyone seen my tag, Body Spray for Men?
Hi, guys.
God, stop that man. I gotta stop that man. Oh, boy, he'll stop me. Big deal, big rocket. Thinks he has the world in his pocket. God, stop, God, stop, God.
That somehow I trust it may embarrass you to hear me say it, but say it I must. You have the cool, clear eyes of a seeker of wisdom and truth. Yet there's the upturned chin and the grin of impetuous youth. Oh, I believe in you. I believe in you. I hear the sound of prudent, solid judgment whenever you talk.
Ha ha ha!
Yes. Oh, we've been waiting for you. Bring him in. It's Finch.
No. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present my new approach to wicked advertising. It's based on an idea which, in my humble opinion, is brilliant.
Sounds great, Finch. Proceed.
Oh, jeez.
The worldwide lady treasure girl.
What is this?
This is the new twist on a television show. I'm combining greed and sex. Go ahead, Betty.
Hello, Sarah. I am the worldwide naked treasure girl. And each week I'll bring you a new clue toward the worldwide treasure husband's stash.
Sarah.
Barry. Oh, yeah. I'm so confused. Hello, Sarah.
Very nice, Miss Lurie.
Of course. This is the reason we are a regular treasure girl.
Naturally.
When we go on the air, we need a big name personality. Offhand, I'd say the market is perfect for someone like Queen Latifah.
What about Queen Elizabeth?
This is an American program. Now, offhand, I'd say with 50,000 shares of stocks and the treasure girl, the program will really...
Hey, let's sell this maniac off and get on with our business.
Ladies, gentlemen, and Mr. LaRue, please excuse Fenchin. I wish to speak with him privately.
Okay, take care. But what about the SEC? What about the shady investigation?
We're all being attentive, Dave.
Finch, you've got great ideas, but I'm afraid you've missed the boat.
How?
Well, why does the treasure girl have to be a big name personality?
Sir?
Why can't she be more into the company?
A real worldwide wicked girl?
Yeah. Maybe. Why can't the treasure girl be Miss LaRue?
Brilliant, JB! Miss LaRue, the girl next door! That was brilliant, thank you, JB.
Wasn't bad, was it?
Well, then it's all set.
Finn, where's the treasure going to be hidden?
Ha, no. Only I'm going to know where the treasure is hidden.
I
the
treasure girl's going to I already.
Well, all right, I'll give you the first clip. West of the sun, west of the moon. Where's the treasure? Below me, too.
What the hell is that?
Tough clue, isn't it? But if you'll note, the first letter in each of those is WWWB. Worldwide Wicked Buildings.
You're going to hide the treasure in our buildings.
I'm going to hide 5,000 shares of stock in each of the 10 Worldwide Wicked Buildings.
There'll be mobs of people running all over the house.
JB, a man as brilliant as you could figure it out. You think the common person would?
Good point.
Come back in now.
Ladies, gentlemen, we're going to go ahead with the Worldwide Wicked idea. Now, of course, I want your opinion first.
Well, JB, I think it's absolutely crazy motion.
I like it.
I like it.
We like it!
For over 100 years, we've been Worldwide Wickets. For a wider world presents in living color. And into the better television programming. The Worldwide Wicked Treasure Hunt. Now, for the opening number, we present an authentic traditional folk dance of the bold pirate folk of the Spanish Main. Dance for your pleasure by the jolly Wicked and Wickettes.
JB and myself know where the treasure is hidden, right, JB?
Right.
Hello there. I'm about to give you the first clue to the Worldwide Wicked treasure hunt. In 10 different places in this great country, there are buried 5,000 shares of stock, making a total of 50,000 shares in all. Ooh. For the first clue.
The first clue is...
west of the sun.
One moment, treasure girl. This woman is carrying a Bible. Will you place your right hand on it? Do you swear that there has been no fixing or rigging in connection with this show? And that the clue you are about to give is the truth, the whole truth, free from any trickery, chicanery, or dishonesty?
Is this a real Bible?
Why, of course, Miss LaRue.
What's wrong with her?
She looks surprised.
Well, she is. Henny didn't know about this part. I wanted this part of the show to be completely unrehearsed.
We're gonna get in trouble.
I think it's quite effective.
Do you swear to that, Miss LaRue?
I do.
And secondly, Miss LaRue, do you swear that you yourself do not actually know where the treasure is hidden? Do you swear to that, Miss LaRue? Miss LaRue?
You see, we're gonna get in trouble here.
Why? You and I are the only ones that know where the treasure is. She doesn't know. She?
Do you swear to that, Miss LaRue?
Look, I do not want to give a false rap. I do know where the treasure is. I found it last night. The treasure's in the old world we can build right now.
Jake,
I'm gonna wash up first.
They want you now.
Can
can I at least say goodbye to Rosemary?
Go ahead.
Rosemary, goodbye.
Come along.
I'm sorry, I just know this has never happened.
Finch, why the hell should you go in and face those monsters? Go ahead, run away, escape. I'll pretend I didn't see you. For all blame's on.
No, I'm gonna go in and face them. I thought you'd have to kill me.
If only I could be sure.
Wally, see, I know that I'm president of this company, responsible for anything that happens here, anything that goes on, but I'd like to state now that anything that has happened is not my fault. So, yeah, soon you'll see who's responsible for this whole thing, Wally. Is Finch here yet?
Never even in.
Wally, when he gets here, I'll do all the talking. This is a very slick youngster, Wally.
He's here, sir.
Bigley, I'd like to say...
No speeches, Finch. You know Wally Wolfer. This is the chairman of the board.
Oh, well, how do you...
Like I said, no speeches, Finch. I'd like you to sign this little simple letter of resignation admitting all the blame for anything and everything that you've done while you're here.
All right, I'll do that.
Wait, what?
I'll do what you said. I'll sign and go back to doing what I was doing before you.
And what was it that you were doing before you came here?
I was a window washer.
A window washer.
No kidding. I was a window washer when I first started here. Really? Well, of course. What did you think I did? Rail splitting?
I went to college?
So you're a window washer, eh? Well, yes, sir, Mr. Whopper. Oh, you won't. Okay.
Wally?
So, tell me, Finch.
Oh, call me, Ponty.
All right, Ponty. Boy, it's been a long time since I've had someone to talk to around here. So, Ponty, how did you get involved in all this?
Well, I had a book.
Really?
Yes, it was How to Succeed in Business.
Now, you see, my book was more useful. I booked bets with all the other window washers.
Cleaned up a bundle.
I should have stood in that business.
8 buildings wrecked, our stock is down 5 points.
We're the laughing stock of the industry!
I know, well, it's ghastly.
Ponty, how did all this happen? I mean, I can understand a college man pulling a scheme like this, but... No, no, window washer.
No, come on, well, if there's one thing I won't do, it's take another man's idea, especially when he's the boss's nephew.
You never told me you hired your nephew.
Nephew. See, Wally, he's not really my nephew. He's my wife's nephew. This may look like nepotism, Wally, but it's not. See, I've never shown him any favoritism. In fact, I hate him. No, see, Wally, when he came to me with the idea, I thought it was a lousy idea. And I told him it was a lousy idea. Then he gave me the idea to Finch, and I still thought it was a lousy idea. And I told Finch it was a lousy idea.
So then why did you buy it?
It sounded like a good idea.
Treasure hunts. Treasure girls.
Well, dress it all up. He can't deny that the idea of the treasure girl was all his.
Well, that's true. That was my idea.
And
not
a bad one.
But who the hell picked that bubble-headed tomato?
Wally, you should talk to her. She's really a nice girl.
I intend to.
Well, I think I've got the whole picture now. But the question is, what to do? And who to do it to? Now hold on, Wally. Before you do anything, I'd like to say a few words. About what? Humanity. You see, we're all part of the same cold corporate setup, but deep down, we're all flesh and blood. We're all brothers. Some of us are hungry. Now you may join the elves, my friend, and I may join the shriners,
and other men may carry cards as members of the diners. Still others wear a golden key or small Greek letter pin. But I have learned there's one great club that all of us are in. There is a brotherhood, a man of the Mifflin Brotherhood. A man, a noble time and minds, all human hearts and minds into a brotherhood of man. Golden Brotherhood is free. We give each brotherhood you can. Oh, aren't you proud to be?
Who's considering that?
Because I know it's on your mind. I'd like to clean up the whole thing from top to bottom, but stop and think.
One man may seem incompetent, another not make sense, while others look like final links of company expense. They need a brother's leadership, so please don't do them in. Remember, mediocrity is not a mortal.
You I never liked. But look, I can make it all worth your while. No, I can't. It doesn't pay to be decent. Well, I'm not going to kill her.
You can't make me. I'm just not going to stop it.
Director Jamie, he's the director of our show.
And then there's the pianist. I'm so sorry, Jenny. And then we also have Stella, who's up in the light booth. We have Alex, we have Helen. We have stage show couldn't survive without them. Everyone backstage and up in the light booth. And we just want to give them a big round of applause. Now a few words from our hard-driving, hard-working director.
Thank you.